Hi guys, I'm James Hawkins, and for my game critique, I'll be critiquing Medieval Dynasty. First thing I noticed that I disliked about this game was the lack of character customization. You start off as Rackmere, this character here. You're not actually able to customize anything on it. When I play open world sandbox like this game, I personally like to customize my character. Now you can change the clothes on him, but that's about the most you can do. Next that I didn't really like was the lack of voice interaction with the different NPCs. They say hey and they say bye.
Hello there. Have a good day.
But for the most part, that's all they say. You talk to them, it says it at the bottom, but they say back.
Have a good day.
They don't actually talk. So interaction, I thought, was a little lacking. Also, you know, obviously, no co-op. I play games like this all the time, but I like personally like to play with friends. So, this being not a co-op, which is coming in a year, they said, I thought that was kind of lacking. But, building limit is a big thing for me. As you can see right here, there's buildings. There's multiple types of buildings, but having a building limit, I felt like that I was kind of a killer for me. I like to be able to build as many buildings as I need or as I want. But going on to what I like, I thought the graphics were amazing. The beautiful scenery is just gorgeous. The amount of trees, overall in general, the hills. As you cut down trees, you'll have these stumps. The water, you can see the water. The constant nature sounds is actually pretty neat too. Like you'd be running around, you just hear the birds chirping. You see the different animals, moose make noises as you run around. I like the biggest thing I liked was the NPC recruitment. So your whole goal is to build a village and to become self-sustaining. One way of doing that is you need to recruit people to work in your different little smithy workshops, your different little buildings. So you have to recruit them, and you don't just recruit anybody. You want to recruit people that are suited for the job you need them for. So like as you can see, he's good for excavation, hunting, farming, talking, and fishing, but he's horrible at production. So right now I have him babysitting my chickens, as you can see. But yeah, so recruiting, you know, it really helps, and you become self-sustaining after a while. It takes a little bit of time. It's a little bit of a grind to do it. But I like that. I like being able to recruit my own guys. So then, and it's not just like I said, not just picking whoever and throwing them to whatever you want. You have to be smart with it. And then the variety of animals. You know, there's all types of different animals. There's a couple of different fish, perch, pike, roaches. You can hunt them or fish for them. There's bears, bison, which is the buffaloes, moose. There's deer, there's lynx, there's foxes, there's rabbits. There's just a bunch of different animals to hunt. And then also there is a bunch to raise. You know, you can raise some chickens, which you see, and I have some pigs, and I have a pig sty, but I just don't have no pigs yet. Some geese, get some sheep, some cows, some horses, and some donkeys. So I thought that was pretty neat. All in all, I do recommend this game for everybody if you're interested in trying it out, seeing how it develops a little bit further. Appreciate it. Thank you for watching.